when we are talking about standards and standardization, in fact, it's a good idea to use the global standards, which are internationally accepted. Because when we are talking about information security, the issues can occur anywhere in the world. So it is better to learn from others' mistake, which is anywhere in the world, not only specifically in Middle East. So the organizations in Middle East also are preferring to use international standards, which are published by ISO, which stands for International Organization for Standardization. Now, we have a specific standard about information security, which is ISO IEC 27001. And the name of the standard is Information Security Management Systems Requirement Standard. We can take this standard as the mother standard, as the main standard. And there are other standards which are incorporating, which are supporting a robust information security management system for the organizations. We call them ISO 27000 family of standards. There are various standards in this family. Just to name a few of them, which are mostly used, especially in the Middle East. For example, ISO 27017 standard, which is cloud security. It's about cloud security, that's a guideline standard. We have ISO 27031, which is about cybersecurity. That's a guidelines for cybersecurity. 27032, which is business continuity aspects of information security, or it is known in the market as disaster recovery standard. Also within the same family, 27000 family, we have sector-specific, industry-specific standards, like 27.11, for example, for telecommunications industry, 27.19 for energy industry, and there are many other various versions of these standards, in fact. So in Middle East, these are the mostly the standards that are used, and organizations have an instilled trust for these standards as they are internationally accepted and known. So this is the way that an organization can implement information security management system using these standards and the members of this family to have a robust information security management system. In fact. The reason for that is, in fact, organizations who don't even use any standards or who are not even aware of any standards would still have an information security management. Like securing the information in any way is called information security management, basically. But the problem will be here is this. You know the famous saying, a smart person learns from his or her mistakes, but a wise person learns from others' mistakes. Now, why we are limiting our perspective when we are implementing an information security management? Why we are learning from our own mistakes? Why would we reach to a certain level of maturity following the standards in a soon time, or trying to find our own way in a very long period? So if an organization is looking for what are the experiences of other organizations in the world, what mistakes they have done, what are the good practices that are tested and approved in other parts of the world, we need to use the standards, in fact. So like I said at the very beginning, when answering that question, information security management can exist in any organization. But if we are talking about a systematic approach, which is information security management system, standards will be quite beneficial on that. Not to skip any good practice, not to forget any of them, not to do mistakes or minimize the likelihood of making mistakes when implementing such a management system. And one more important thing I want to point out here is, when we are using the standards, in fact, I can say the highest benefit is to have an effective and efficient management system. Now, effectiveness is about securing information. However, we know that even the richest companies, organizations in the world don't have unlimited resources. So they need to use their resources in an optimum way. So when securing the information, they need to look for efficiency, using their resources, their time, money, human resources, and so on, in an efficient way. So standards also help organizations to determine this balance and to implement a management system that will in fact satisfy, make all interested parties happy, which include top management, employees of the organization, suppliers, customers, of course, and the legal authorities.